this year. Just a couple of points. Yes, surface car parking compared to multi-storey car parking. Yes, we often hear that we prefer surface parking. But I think we have to weigh this against an obligation to get the best possible use we can out of the land area we've got. And we do see the Market Quay area generally as being a prime site to be able to develop, to generate a more viable town centre in terms of dwellings over the top of perhaps additional shops or eateries, and a multi-storey car park in one corner would actually meet the total car park needs of that site. There's a balance in here, isn't there, between how much open space you leave just for cars to sit on, and I suppose meeting what is a prime objective of us, particularly in a town centre. It's a difficult question, but one I think that we address in the correctest way we could. As far as the listed car park is concerned, then yes, there has been some movement of some officers to that car park, but if there's a feeling that the general use of that particular car park has increased particularly dramatically over the last 12 years, I'm sure if we feel that's the case, then we could always do a sub-survey of that car park to better understand what the current use is and by whom.
Very much. And I think Councillor Swinburne is absolutely right to raise issues around our car parks, and without doubt surface parking is very popular compared with multi-storey car parking. I think the issue is that if we didn't look at these options, that's 124 dwellings we're looking at on those two car parks, then we need a green field for 124 dwellings. And if you want to have a little chat to the residents around that green field, potentially if we were going to use that instead for another 124 dwellings, because we say no, we're not going to build in our car parks, then of course they may take some issue with you. So we're trying to look at the least worst options, and we do have a policy of brownfield first, and that's what we're looking at those areas for. But we're not looking at losing spaces there. Sorry.
Thank you, Chairman. I did say at the beginning, I have no objection to having housing there.
Yeah.
I totally agree with the idea of using brownfield sites, of which there are plenty within the town centre, and I've only raised a couple of queries for further inspection.
As I said, I did not write to raise those queries, and you're right to acknowledge that at least the least worst option is to use these brownfield sites, particularly where they are owned by the borough councils, which have a real control over their use. Right, and what I'm going to do now then is let's just deal with Fareham Town Centre then as a whole, because those we've done with other areas, because those two are within. So if we can look at the FTC sites, Fareham Town Centre sites, from 1 through to 10. And does anybody wish to discuss or comment on any one of those, or all of them in general, or not at all, make a decision? Right, okay. Then can I see those in favour of allocating 577 brownfield site dwellings on the sites FTC 1 to 10. Anybody think that's where it is?